Before we get into today's video, only 38.2% of you guys are subscribed to the channel, so if you enjoy the content that you see here, ladies and gentlemen, I think you should hit that subscribe button and hit the notification bell and hit the like button too, because I promise you won't regret it. And without further ado, let's go ahead and get into today's video. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Trasher Football. Today is episode 3 of the first Dynasty series with the Appalachian State Mountaineers. Last time where we left off, we upset Clemson in the most insane comeback game in the history of the channel. We came down 34-7 with 7 minutes left until halftime and came back to win 41-40. Our next game is going to be at ECU, so this is going to be a very important away game to start out the season. I do want to see what type of uniforms ECU has, and I think I really just want to see those all purples. And I love those chrome purple helmets, by the way. And I think while we're at it, we're going to run the gold, white, gold, as we sometimes normally do on the road. Without further ado, let's go ahead and get into it. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Dowdy Ficklin Stadium. What a name for a stadium. This is, I think our... this is a interconference matchup. This is Sunbelt and the American, isn't it? All right. Looks like we're going to kick off to start the game. We are underway at ECU. And they don't seem to have a big crowd here today. Jake Garcia will be the starting quarterback for the Pirates. And this should be a really fun game because our offense with Joey Aguilar is really fun to play with. Makes the throw in the RPO and automatically makes a big play, and he breaks two tackles. Finally broke another one and then finally got taken down. Number 13, if he's going to play like that all game, he's going to be detrimental to this defense. And they're already calling for the no huddle. First and 10, 20 seconds have gone by. And they're already in App State territory. Got a man in motion. Going to the right. Throw left. Already another decent play right there for a gain of 8. Alright, second and 2. Alright. Go with a run up the middle. Gonna get tackled short. Third and 1. I say we pinch and run commit here. I think they're running it again. And they are, and it works. It's going to be 4th and 1. And they're going to go for the field goal here. MC Contos? Kick is up, and that's going to be good. I mean, he was on the team from last season, so I think that there's reason to believe that he's going to end up being very good. All right, let's see what we can do right here on 1st and 10. Wow, what a play. And that's a touchdown for App State. Wow, what a good 3rd down conversion for the touchdown. Kick is up and it is good. App State takes a 7-3. Oh, gonna go deep. Incomplete. Good defense right there. 2nd and 10. Minute 44 remaining in the first. Gonna go with a rush. And missed the tackle. Finally gets pushed out of bounds after the first. Gonna go with another rush to the left. And he, for some reason, just won't catch up to tackle, and he finally goes down at the 4. What was that? Okay, 1st and goal now. Throw to the end zone, gonna go out the back. 2nd and goal. Let's go. Gonna throw right, and he's just gonna be short. Third and goal. Good defense right there. All right, third and goal on the one, right on the goal line. Gonna go up the, nope, to the right, and he just barely gets in. Almost got the tackle right there, but ECU takes the lead. Ten to seven. And gonna go out to circle for a gain of nine. Or 1 yard away from the first down. Joey Aguilar's already thrown for 130 yards and a touchdown. And we get the first. That should do it for the first quarter. Where ECU has a 10-7 lead. Interesting, interesting. All right, here we go. Why do people just love to message me? And it's going to be a little bit of a decent gain of six. Touchdown, Appalachian State. And we take the lead back. And the kick is up and it is good. Gonna go with another rush. And they're gonna get 1 yard, make it fourth and three, and they're gonna have to go for another field goal. Almost blocked. And it's barely just good. All right, on the kickoff, App State will get the ball with a 1 point lead. Kickoff return, tries to find a hole, but doesn't. Gonna get it out to the 19. All right, first and 10, 2:27 remaining. Almost got the catch. If we send Caden Robinson out on a streak, maybe get a one-on-one ball here. Almost caught it, man. That's going to be third down. Big third down right here. What a play. Good play decision right there. Man, Joey Aguilar is looking good today. Only, what, three incompletions? 12 of 15, I think it said. Another good play for another big first down. And this team's looking fun to play with. Out the back of the end zone, touchdown, App State. And they're going to extend their lead to eight instead of the normal four of what it's been looking like. With big chunk yards, they're probably going to end up with more first downs than we are. Picked off by Appalachian State by number two. And he's going to take it to the house. Touchdown, App State. Ethan Johnson on the pick six. And he's going to get sacked again on 4th and 10. And I'm going to call a timeout. And they're going to punt. We're going to try and get some more points with 27 seconds left. Like a 2-minute drill. Except it's 27 seconds. Yeah, wish that could have been a better punt return. All right. There goes Aguilar for the first and the timeout. Got it. 13 seconds remaining. And I really hope that we can get a big... Oh, probably shouldn't have done that. Yep, I knew it. I knew it as soon as I let go of the ball that that would have been a pick. And that's going to give them 6 seconds to score. Incomplete, and they're going to take it to halftime. 28-13 lead. And man, that pick is really going to hurt the stats of Aguilar today. Because he's just been having a great game. What an offense right there. 222 passing yards just in the first half. Some quarterbacks don't even do that in a whole game. And the kickoff for the second half. Take it to the end zone. For the touchback. Play action. First down. ECU's JD Lampley is hurt on the play. Caught? Nope, incomplete. I really thought he held on to that. Also incomplete. Man, both of those should have been catches. What was that throw? He threw it just right into the hands of the DB. That's just an awful drive. Not even a good punt either. Out to the 25. On the left hash. Gonna go with a run. Only gonna get four. Rajay Harris. And that's going to be another first. Down to the 39. ECU trying to stay in the game. Going to go no huddle here. Got some movement. Moving again. And that's complete again. First and 10 in App State territory now. Good play right there by the defense. Incomplete, swatted down by the DB. And they're going to go for a field goal again. This is going to be a long one right here. Kick is up. It's good. Three consecutive field goals in this game for ECU. They'll put their score at, what, 19? 16. Not a bad return, out to the 24. All right, first and 10, 45. Caught in stride, trying to get some space, but it's going to get tackled on the 26-yard line. Hetzel is having a good game. It's 100 receiving yards on the day. Gonna get the blocks. Couldn't cut left in time. Second and 7. Play action. No, it's picked off again. It's going to get tackled on the 1 yard line. And offense is not looking good in the second half, man. That's going to be a safety. A safety. And I guess I'll kind of take it. I'll take it from the pick. And that's going to be the punt from the safety. It's going to be returned by number 26. Gets nothing. On the 35 now. First and 10. Number two, who was that? Cade Robinson? Is that who that is? Joey Aggie. Nope. Joey's the one who threw it. We're going to have a really good second half compared to the first. And there goes Aguilar, and he's going to take it. And he's going to bring it out for the touchdown. That's something this offense desperately needed after throwing for two picks. Wow. For the complete. Oh, no, he dropped it. It was incomplete. Good DB play right there to break it up. Third and 10. And they're going to run it. And it's going to work out. And he's got running room, and that's going to be an ECU touchdown. And the kick's up, and it's good. 37-23. And just the defense just cannot do anything. Touchback. Down 14 now. Gets only two. Man, they're clutching up now. And that's going to be an easy play out to the tight end for the first down. And he's going to keep it for himself. Touchdown, Joey Aguilar. Two rushing touchdowns on the day now. Extends the lead back to 21. 44-23. Oh, wow. I tried picking that off, and he caught it. Insane play for ECU. And the kick's up, and it's good. It shortens the lead back to 14. And they're going to go the onside kick. I didn't expect that. Okay, and we retrieved it. All right. Time to run out some clock here, ladies and gentlemen, just so that way we can take this game home, and because I'm tired of this game already. Good rush by Haywood. I don't know why I did that. I don't think he was short. I think he got it. Offense has just looked... Wow, and he dropped it. There was just a wide open man in the end zone, too. I'm an idiot. I am such an idiot. And we miss it. Kicking sucks in this game. I hate it. I hate the new kicking. I've made maybe 7 field goals out of 30-something in the last few days. I probably make 1 out of every 5 field goals I kick. And that's going to be the 2-minute warning. Down 14. They still have all 3 timeouts. Didn't even try and tackle him. What was that all about? They're going to go with a no huddle. And that's going to be incomplete. 3rd and 3. On the 38. Incomplete. Swatted down. This play will decide the game. Wow, and he caught it. Ready? Wow, wow, defense, man. Defense is looking sloppy. There we go. Only a gain of one. That's going to continue the clock. They need to score now if they need to stay in it, because they're going to need to get an onside kick now. And he's going to take it out of bounds to stop the clock. Third and six now. Fourteen-point game with a minute, 06 and counting left. Hit on the throw, fourth and six. Could this be the game? On fourth and six. And he's going to get sacked. Turnover on downs. And that'll be it. He's going to take some runs. Pushed him out of bounds. Not what I wanted. But Miguel deserves some playing time. Another timeout. Well, not another, but yeah. Timeout. Take the knee. And that's going to run out the clock. And App State comes to East Carolina. Wins 44-30. Not a good second half by App State, but the first half is what really kept them in the game. Joey Aguilar wins player of the game. 402 passing yards, 5 touchdowns, 2 picks. Really good game for Aguilar. He just needs to work on the interceptions. Look at the full game stats. Joey Aguilar, 21 for 33, 402, 3 touchdowns, 2 picks. Miguel Haywood, 9 rushes, 61 yards, 0 touchdowns. But Aguilar, 6 rushes, 41 yards for 2 touchdowns. Receiving, Caden Robinson had the best game, unless you want to say Hetzel because of his touchdown catches. Really good game by them. Not a bad game. Not a bad game at all. That was a decent game against ECU. You know, we got the win. It was an away game. It's going to extend our record to 3-0 to start out the first season. And, hey, we got a commit. Dante Shorter, the left end from Georgia. So that's not bad. And that's going to bring it into the next weekend. Ethan Johnson won Sunbelt Defensive Player of the Week. All right. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for watching today's episode. Make sure to hit the subscribe button and leave a like down below and turn the notifications bell on, because I promise you won't regret it. Hope you guys all have a wonderful day, and I'll see you guys later.